We'll move on a condition builder. Actually, we are defining a virtual way in our workflow which will be followed on a specific condition. How to use it and how to build it. Let's move on. In a JavaScript, I'll make a variable which value is 5. And now I'll paste here condition builder and attach it to the workflow. When you edit, you can add here a path which will be followed on a specific condition. Here I'll add two path. You can rename it by click on a pencil icon. Let's name our define for 1 and 2. Edit here first path. Now add here condition. Trot on it and here I'll give a variable name v. Define a specific condition equal case and insensitive and not equal and so on. Value of our variable v is equal to 1, then this path will be follow. Edit here was 2. I expect it will be 2. Now I'll edit here value of variable firstly 1 and here I'll place form which will be follow on a condition which is for 1. I'll connect with this node and choose here element. I choose the email. Now I'll type for 1 value. Now same copy in this case for value 2. Now I'll place here for value 2. For value of variable b is equal to 1, then a first form will be executed. And if in condition of value is equal to 2, then a second block of form will be follow. Maybe you have a question, what will do if not a condition 1 and neither 2, and what will do? That's really makes sense. So in this case, there's a fallback will be this node will be executed. Change here a value of variable where its value will be 2. In this case, value will be 2. When a text of an element is according to our condition, then we'll follow it. It's 3. Now I'll clear just form. We'll see that it will not execute a form, any one of them. Now it's not execute any form because it's a fallback is execute. You can see it's a form log. As you can see, condition it's execute, but form is not execute. I was making a simple condition to make understandable. You can make a more complex. Even you can use here a complex condition building.